Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm going to render this, make it clear what blasphemy is. Because some people, you know, they are doubting, you know, what blasphemy is. So that the thing become clear. If you read John 9, the born blind person whose eyes Jesus opened with his spittle, it tells you everything, what type of people Jesus is seeking. What is a new skin? He was not drunk with the old wine of the letters. People, when they get drunk with the old wine of the letter, they get spiritually blind. You read Bible? John the Baptist said that I am baptizing in water, the one coming after me will baptize you in Holy Spirit. And when you ask these people, dog-colored people and priests and other things, then in whose name John the Baptist baptized in water? Because he did not baptize in Holy Spirit, Father, Son and all that. They have no answer, but they are reading the Bible like a novel, without understanding. So this is the type of discerning intellect the common man has. So unless you are a man of discerning intellect, as those at the time of Jesus, when they saw that what the rabbis were doing was opposite what they were telling the other people. The other people, they told them, don't tell lies, but they were telling lies, knowingly, that is against the moral law. And that is called blasphemy or hypocrisy. So when they noticed these things, you know, they disassociated themselves from the rabbis, and they were seeking somebody spiritually advanced to tell them about spiritual things which the Samaritan rabbi knew, but the Jewish rabbis, they hated Samaritans. They won't let anybody to go there into the Samaritan village and become knowledgeable. So they kept them away from the light, so much so that even today, the people, you know, if they want to go across Samaria, they won't pass through Samaria. They will circumvent it, go around it, and not through it. Samaria is the region of the generation of Joseph, whom they sold to Egyptian as a slave. And as soon as he left the promised land, whatever meager they were eating, that stopped. And they went hungry and went to beg food from Egypt, which Joseph supplied. He obliged them with the food, and they kicked him in his face. And that is called saltless people. Even today, they are saltless people. When Jesus was sitting in the temple and he was telling them that your forefathers were devil, and they said, are you a Samaritan that you are calling so? That means Samaritans were more enlightened than these Jewish people. They used to point finger at them. Useless people. And so much so that they have twisted the Bible, that this Samaritan woman at the well, she had five husbands. Five were spiritual husbands, and they have told the congregation by the letters of the what is written that that woman had five husbands. She was marrying one husband after the other, and she was a bad woman. In Orthodox, she is known as Saint Fotina. She was a saint, and they call her a bad woman. Even in Oxford University, I went there and asked them, would you like the company of that Samaritan woman at the well, which had five husbands, or would you like the company of the Jerusalem theologians? Oh, the one old lady over there, you know, professor, you know, she said, oh, we don't like that Samaritan woman. She had five husbands. She was a bad character, and so. But we like the company of the Jerusalem theologians. They are men of letters, dead in spirit, as the present theologians are. So you won't get anything out of these present theologians. They are hypocrites. So in John 9, the born blind person story, and Jesus told those rabbis that they are blind guides of the blind. Then one of them retorted that, are you calling me blind? Then Jesus said that, now I know that you are not blind, but doing things wrong knowingly. So this is more serious than sin, called blasphemy. Dog-collared hireling priests in the churches, they are not working for God, but working for Mammon. And they are paid in Mammon from the church purse, which amounts to the same thing as stealing in the manner of Judas Iscariot. Remember, Judas Iscariot used to hold the purse, you know, money. So whenever he wanted something, he would steal money from the purse to buy it. And that's why when that woman was spilling ointment on Jesus, which was expensive, Judas Iscariot said, that could have been sold for 300 denarii, and the money could have been given to the poor. And that is what they will tell you in the churches, you know, that we are collecting this money for poor. And that man himself, you know, with dog collar, working for Mammon, man of letters, not spirit, is Judas Iscariot in the church, in sheep's clothing. So if this is the intelligence of the people who attend these churches, then what can you expect? Nothing. If your priests cannot enter into the royal kingdom of God, how could they lead others? Are they blasphemers like those hypocrite rabbis? Real Christianity is through house groups. When you are house group, 2, 3, or 4 gather together, 10 people, then everyone has a chance to ponder over and speak from his own mouth. Remember that his word cannot be written down in ink on paper. It is written on your heart, tablets of heart. And when people speak, they are speaking from their hearts. They are trying to find out the meaning behind what is the saying is. And they then, through logical reasoning, get logos. And logos is his word. So real Christianity through house groups of royal priests. We are royal priests here. We are not hireling. Where people ponder over his word and no more prayer to our Heavenly Father Yahweh. Yahweh is the one who was alienated by the rabbi. But Jesus had introduced to us our Father which lives in this house. Yahweh and fasting like the disciples of rabbis, Pharisees, Sadducees, etc. We carry the temple of God. This is the temple of God with us. And our Father lives in his temple called Emmanuel. so far you worship him in truth and in spirit. Truth. Christ Peter killed two liars for telling lies, Ananias and Sapphira. And these liars become hypocrites, making the church full of lip service and sugar-coated sermons of the Antichrist, hireling, dog-collared priest, delivering or occupying the church. They occupy the church. They are the leader, you know. So they are the one who tell what to do to the people, as other people are blind. These Messianic Jews, soon after occupying the church, you know, in the first century, they killed apostles. And in 300 AD, got the house churches banned by the decree of the Roman Emperor Constantine. So when they were banned, then people have to join the mainline church, which is the Synagogue of Satan. And that is where the mess has landed up today. So if you want to know Jesus, go back to the house churches and ponder over his word. Don't waste your time on prayer and fasting, because before the things come on your lip, our Father knows what is in your heart, and he fulfills your wishes. You don't need to ask him. He knows it already. In short, light came among his own, people of the Judah tribe especially, and his own loved darkness to light, becoming super blind. So if the people become super blind and they lead the blind to the sectarian rites, as you are observing now in Iraq and other people killing each other, Church of England, church over there, Church England is here. What is the church over there doing? Church of England is headed by Queen is head of Mammon. So is a church headed by Mammon, and you have super blind guides, and that's why people are killing each other. So who is to be blamed? The people themselves. They are not awakening to the message delivered by our anointed elder brother Christ Jesus. So these politicians, they become politicians by delivering sugar-coated sermons. They are not capable of speaking the gospel truth. For example, Jew is one who is inwardly and not outwardly, not flesh. Flesh is of Levi tribe, Judah tribe, Benjamin tribe, tribal. When you become Jew outwardly, then you replace your tribe with Jew. When you replace the tribe with Jew, then you break your covenant with Abraham, become unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh. So what you expect then? Like those 11 crooks, when they sold the Joseph, who was faithful to Abraham, to Egyptian as a slave, the land became barren. They have to beg for food. So same is spiritually, you become orphan, because you have said bye-bye to your creator Yahweh. Yahweh is the creator of male and female flesh. That's why the name is of Jesus is Yeshua. Yeah, from Yahweh, Shua means Adam, the firstborn of Adam. Mary was surrogate mother, and Joseph was foster father. So the real father of Jesus is, heavenly father is Yahweh. And the Christ is the light inside, which we call Nur, light. So the light, Christ is from our Father Light, which is Spirit. And those who are sons of the Light are sons of the Spirit, our Father, they are Christ. They are preaching the word of our Father. So Christ dwells inside. Like Jew who is never born, never die, Christ is never born, never die, because it's a spiritual self, not the physical self. During partition of India, not a Hindu or Sikh died, not a single Hindu, Sikh or a Muslim died, but the tribal people died. But most of them had no knowledge, blind. My father had this knowledge. 2,000 people came to attack our village. And when my father told them that we tribal people going to fight with each other and kill each other, not Sikh and Muslim, which are spiritual self, the headman of the attacking party understood it. And he told the 2,000 people to look after us like their guest. And they did it. Have you come across such an example in whole of those sectarian riots? Nowhere. So people of discerning intellect, they are very few. And there are people who are seeking, but they don't get guidance. There's nobody to satisfy their hunger, spiritual hunger. I was lucky to be born in a family where my father was enlightened, and he himself was seeking his word through logical reasoning, and so I learned from him to think logically, not to take anything for granted. When you think logically, you will find treasures which you will be surprised that nobody knows it. Hardly 1 in 1,000, and 2 in 10,000 will know gospel. That's what Christ Thomas said. Among Sikhism, 1 in 1,000,000, because there are more greed there. When you are greedy, you don't get his word. So with this note, I hope I've made it clear that the word is full of hypocrites. And to fight against hypocrisy is his word. Nothing else can fight hypocrisy but by exposing the hypocrite. Like I have exposed these hireling dog collar people. They are working for money, telling people they are working for God. If they are working for God, then God should pay them in his own currency, which is gospel. But they are not having any gospel. They have letters, dead letters. They go to university to learn letters. They pay to the person over there. He is a hireling himself, professor. They pay him, then they want to make money, retrieve it. If you find a spiritual man, he won't charge you. He received freely he will give you. And that man will give you gospel. Those are sadhus of Melchizedek type. So we royal priests are of the type of Melchizedek, but we are living in our family home, enjoying the facility living in a house instead of living in the wilderness. So we are trying our best to produce the best fruit, but these worldly affairs, the weeds, they choke the fruit, and we produce 60%. And those who go to wilderness become roving preachers, they gain 100% fruit. 30% is doubting people, 60 those who are sealed to serve God. I put lot of videos on YouTube, and if you want the Google, if any subject you want, you know, who is the creator, God is spirit, put God is spirit, comma, my surname Niger, N-I-J-J-H-A-R, and Google it, you will find a lot of videos on the topic. Any topic you want, say sin, blasphemy, anything, just Google it, you get the answer. So you get a detailed answer rather than I giving each person an answer again, because I like to make more videos. And that will give me chance to, you know, spend more time on my own preaching gospel to everyone. Our Father God blesses you.